Okay, we're going to look at hooking up a foreign outlet here in the country I'm born in. We use 120 volts, but overseas they are 220, 240. So I'm going to show you how I can make it work. So first is we have the box that they use over there. And it has a little knockout on the back here. So I'm going to just drill a little hole through here so my hole's not too big. Take a little while to drill. There we go. We got our little hole drilled here. Okay, so we'll slide our wire through here carefully. Push it back against the wall. We'll put in there and we'll screw it in. The holes are back in here. Okay, so we'll take a vacuum cleaner and we'll get our little burrs out of here. Okay, so we'll take our knife here and we'll just very, very carefully score down the middle of the wire. We want it to go in between the live and the neutral. We'll use our side cutters here and we'll cut all of our debris out so it's all nice and neat. And I'll push these wires down. Okay, so this is the receptacle they use over there. This is the German style. And we'll clip our wires so that we can hook it up. The ground is going to come down over the top, so we're going to push that into the back. We're going to make sure this bare ground wire is back out of the way of everything. And the black and the white stays down. We'll slide this in like this. And that's how it will screw into the box like that. So we're going to have to clip and strip our wires. Make sure I'm in the 14 hole here. Now over there they use a 1.5 square millimeter, so that is very slightly smaller than our 14. Now here we have our wires are polarized, our sockets are all polarized. So I had to bring these up. Okay, so I'm going to loosen these terminals here. It has like a little pressure plate inside here. The screw to fall out. Now they are not polarized, so it doesn't matter which side you put the black and the white on. So I'm gonna go underneath like this. Start pushing this in. Get our ground wire to come through here. Okay, now this screw screws in up here. Okay, I'm going to move that black wire a little bit, so I'm going to tighten my connections. I'm going to pull this little piece out here so I can maneuver this black wire so it goes down in the way I want it to go. So there's how it's going to fit like that. So I can put this back in. Okay, I meant to push the white one over too. Here we go. And now it's where we want it. And we'll put our two screws in here. Over there, they'd have a black and a blue. Over there, black is live and blue is neutral. But here where I'm born, black is live and white is neutral. Okay, so now all we have now is to hook up this ground wire. So we have to just clip it so it's going to fit right in there nice. We'll just clip it like that. Okay, I'm going to have to play with it a little bit here to get the ground in where I want it. I may have to just take the screw out all the way. The ground wire down under the pressure plate that's going to be in place here. Okay, so I'm going to have to put this pressure plate back in, get the screw in here. It's going to be kind of tricky so I don't lose it. And guess what? I lost it. So I got to just reach down here with my pliers and get it out. Okay, so what I'm going to do is hold it with my pliers here, like this. This is going to be tricky. There we go, you got it. I don't like how it made a contact there, so I'm going to loop the ground wire, so I'm going to just pull it out again. And I'll have to go down here with my pliers and get the plate out again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, and I'm going to make a little loop with this ground wire here. A little bit and bring it down and make a little loop here. There. And we'll try getting this plate in here again. We'll do the same thing here with the pliers. little bugger wants to be tough, so you gotta just deal with it. You don't want to lose your patience. You know what, it just doesn't seem to want to go, so sometimes you just have to go back to ground zero and start all over again. Sometimes it's better just to go back to ground zero and start all over again. Just go ahead and tip it forward. In the hole. There it goes. There, now we got it the way that we want it. So now we just gotta get the wire to sit back in here again the way that it should be sitting. So we will just bend it back and we'll just push it back in here. So we're going to do some shaping here to make it fit. Now everything all fits the way we want it. So we'll make sure our connections are tight. One, two, three. And I'll give you a close-up of what it looks like in the back here. Okay, so now we will finish the assembly. We will put this cover on like this. and sits in like this. This goes in like this. And this screw just goes in like this. Together, and I will go downstairs and I'll show you how it's hooked up in the breaker box. Okay, I have it hooked up to a double pole 20 amp or 15 amp circuit breaker. See, it's a two pole. Take our meter and check it. We will put it on 300 volts and we'll put it in here. Okay, we're getting 241 volts. Now, what's different with the outlets here in the country I'm born in? We have 120 volts, and it's on the brass screw to the neutral, and it's polarized. See how one slot is narrower than the other? And it's 120 volts live to neutral. And this is the European standard. It would be 220 or 240 phase to neutral, but here it's 120, 120, 240 total. So check with the manufacturers and check your with a qualified technician before a installing a European outlet in your house, and consult with authorized personnel before doing and installing and using. Peace. Thanks for watching.